Here's Mama Bloom's Brood. Sidney and Harold's suggestion that Papa Bloom retire from business met with mixed reactions. Papa was not taken with the idea. Mama thought it was pretty good. So good, in fact, that she bought two tickets for a trip to Yellowstone Park without consulting Papa, whom she brought around to her way of thinking as only Mama can. Right now, we find Mama Bloom at home, just finishing a telephone conversation with Sarah.
Yeah, Sarah. Yeah. You and Sidney should come over here tonight. Yeah, then Harold will be here. Yeah. Sarah... Bring the little picture books about Yellowstone Park, eh? Right? Oh, yeah. Papa wants to go now, yeah. Oh, Sarah. Sarah, your papa's home, so we'll hang up now. Yeah. Then we'll see you this evening? Good. Goodbye, Sarah. Yeah, darling, goodbye.
Yeah, hello, Becky.
Hello, Jake. You're home a little early.
Well, I thought I would come home and talk things over with you.
Is something wrong, Papa?
No, Becky, there's nothing wrong.
Then what is there to talk about?
Mama, should we always talk about trouble that we can't find anything else to talk about?
No, Jake, no. Did you see Sam and tell him you're going to take a little vacation?
Well, Mama, I saw Sam, but I didn't tell him.
Why not?
Well, I thought maybe I would tell him later.
Jake, the longer you put things off, the more you'll have to tell him later. You should have told him right of it.
But, Mama, Sam is not yet used to Sidney and Harold around the factory. Too many things I can't tell him at once. I have to take it easy.
Well, I guess so, Jake.
Of course, Mama. Becky, have you got the little picture books about Yellowstone Park?
No, not yet.
No?
Sarah's bringing them over here tonight, and then we'll look at them. Jake?
Yes, Mama?
You're liking it now, ain't you?
Liking what, Mama?
Jake, don't talk like that. You know what I mean. 2 days ago, you didn't like the idea of going away. Today, you come home early from the factory so you can look at pictures about where we are going.
Yeah, you're right, Mama. We'll have a good time.
Sure, Jake.
Sure. And Mama, tell me something. Mm-hmm. Tell me, how did it happen that you should pick Yellowstone Park for a vacation?
Jake, I'll tell you. One day, I'm walking down the street, and I see a sign that says Yellowstone National Park, the place for a vacation. So I just told Sarah to buy the ticket for it.
You saw a sign, he says. I see. You know something, Mama?
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad you didn't pass a sign about Siberia.
Jake, that's foolish. Yellowstone I'll go to, but Siberia's no place for a vacation.
Siberia, Mama, is no place for nothing. But look, Becky, when do you think we should go?
Maybe in a week.
A week? Why did you buy the tickets if you didn't know when you wanted to go?
I bought the tickets because I thought we would be able to use them.
All right. And how much did you pay for them?
I paid what the man wanted.
But how much did he want, Mama?
Now, Jake, the other day you promised me that if we are going on a vacation, you wouldn't worry about the business.
And I won't, Becky. I promise.
Then you shouldn't worry about the price of the ticket.
Yeah, no, but maybe it would be nice to know. Maybe sometime later, Mama, I'd want to get some more tickets, you see?
No, Jake, no. Look, we are going away to have a good time. Mm. If you worry about how much this is costing, about how much that's going to be, then you'll spend all your time with a pencil in your hand. And you'll have no time to look at the scenery.
Yeah. All right, Becky, all right. And now maybe we can decide when we are going?
Maybe. But first I'll have to buy some new clothes and you'll have to buy some new clothes.
I'll have to buy new clothes? Why?
Jake, don't be foolish. You got to look nice when you're going traveling.
Well, maybe we could travel so fast nobody would see us,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, then we wouldn't see anything either. Jake, I think you should get some new suits so you look nice.
Well, don't I look nice now?
Jake, you look lovely. you look nice, but you can look very nice and you still not look nice for our trip.
Mama, when you look nice. That's good sense. It makes sense. So how can you not look nice when you do look nice?
All right, Jake, all right.
All right, all right.
I'm saying that you got a dress to take our trip just the same as you got a dress to go to our wedding.
All right, Mama. So I'll get another suit to wear on the train, maybe with an extra pair of pants, some shirts, shoes.
That's good, Jake, that's good. And Jake?
Yes, Mama.
Maybe you could even wear pants like Sidney wears sometimes.
Pants like Sidney? Mama, what is the difference about the pants Sidney wears? Just the size.
I forget the name of them, but you should maybe get a pair.
How could I get a pair when you don't even know what kind you mean, Mom?
Like the kind he wears on picnics. Knickers. They're like knee pants.
Knee pants? Knee pants? Mama, for you I will go to Yellowstone Park. For you I will do anything in the world. Anything but wear knee pants. For 20 years, Mama, I made them. But for 20 years, I stayed out of them. And now I'm not going to get in them.
Papa, you're old-fashioned.
I like to be old-fashioned. Then I know what I'm doing. What would Sam say if he saw me walking around in a pair of knee pants? He would think I was taking the stock out of the storeroom. The neighbors would think, poor Jake Bloom. He's got two son-in-laws that make uniforms. So he's got to wear knee pants so people will know he's still in the knee pants business. No, Mama, emphatically no.
All right, Papa. So we don't talk you about it, huh?
That's good.
Yeah.
And now, Mama, we...
The doorbell, Jake.
The maybe it's Sarah with the picture book.
No, not yet. Couldn't be. Answer the doorbell, Jake.
All right, Mom. All right. Don't push me.
Well, good afternoon, Mr. Bloom. Is Mrs. Bloom in?
Yeah, Becky's in, Mrs. Bing. In the parlor.
So I just stopped in for a little minute. I'm on my way to the bridge club.
Oh, we're glad you did, Mrs. Bing. We're glad. Becky! Here goes Mrs. Bing.
Jake, I got eyes. Hello, Mrs. Fink.
Hello, Mrs. Bloom. I just dropped in for a little minute.
Very glad. Sit down, Mrs. Fink.
For just a little bit. Harold tells me you're going away.
For just a little bit.
Oh, that will be nice. Of course, you're going abroad.
Abroad? Where's that?
Mama, that means Europe.
Oh. Well, what would we see in Europe that's not in America, Mrs. Fink?
Why, Europe.
So we live in America, we work in America, so we see America. They're going to Yellowstone Park.
Well, everybody to his own taste. But a trip abroad would be so delightful. Yellowstone Park is nice, but the novelty wears off after a little while.
The book said it's there for maybe thousands of years. Why should it wear out when we want to see it?
Mama, Mrs. Fink means that when you see it more than once, you don't like to see it anymore.
I saw a moving picture four times once, and I liked it better each time.
Well, maybe you like Yellowstone Park. I will never forget the first time Monroe and me, we saw the geysers.
Excuse me. What is it you saw?
The geyser.
Oh, the geysers. You see, Jake, you learned something new. You're going to see geysers.
Yeah. Well, Mama, that would be very nice if we only knew what a geyser is.
Oh, Jake, you'll find out what a geyser is. Imagine that, Mrs. Pinky, don't know what a geyser is.
Yeah. Well, what is it?
Never mind, Jake. Half the fun of traveling is to see things you don't know about. If you knew everything, then there wouldn't be anything to see. If there wasn't anything to see, then everybody would stay home. And when everybody stays home, everybody hugs.
But, Mama, I still want to know what a geyser is.
Mrs. Fink, tell Jake what a geyser is.
Well, it's like a fountain. Water goes up in the air.
A fountain? To see that, we could go for a walk in Central Park.
But this fountain has hot water.
Hot water? Mrs. Fink, are you sure you was in Yellowstone Park?
Of course. You know, there is one geyser they call Old Faithful. Every so many minutes, it goes up in the air.
Oh, like a busted water pipe.
That's right.
Can't they fix it?
They don't want to fix it, Becky. People all come to see it and take pictures of it.
So, you see, Mama, we're going to see a lot of things. Yes. And when I get home, I'll have pictures to show Sam. And when he asks me what I saw, I will show him a picture of a fountain that throws hot water up in the air. And do you know what he'll say, Mama?
No.
Fui.
Well, of course, for people who've never seen it before, it's a treat. The water goes hundreds of feet up in the air. And there's nothing that makes it go up.
Mrs. Fink, maybe you better stop telling us about Yellowstone Park and the geysers. When we see them, we will believe them.
Mama, don't you believe what Mrs. Fink is telling us?
Sure, Papa, sure. I believe Mrs. Fink.
Monroe and I are going to Hollywood as soon as he clears up some business.
Business? How is his business, Mrs. Fink?
Oh, I don't know. I never pay any attention to it. Business is for Monroe.
Why are you going to Hollywood, Mrs. Fink?
Well, we've been every place else. Monroe has a cousin out there who's going to take us around and show us the town.
Nice. When you're going to leave?
Oh, maybe in a month, maybe 2 months. Have you ever been on the coast, Mrs. Bloom?
To Coney Island.
Well, once you get to traveling, you can't stop. Of course, Monroe and I have been so many places. If there's anything you want to know, you ask us. We'll tell you.
Yeah, you did already. Tell me, Mrs. Fink, you never been to Hollywood before?
Well, no. Monroe and I went to San Francisco, but we didn't stay long, so we couldn't go to Hollywood.
Yeah, I see.
Well, I have to be going along to my bridge club now. Monroe and I want you to come over before you leave for Yellowstone Park. Come some afternoon for tea.
Oh, I never drink tea, Mrs. Fink, but I'll take some coffee.
Sure, Mrs. Fink, sure.
So glad to see you again.
Yeah, Papa, huh? For Mrs. Fink to the door.
Oh, huh? Maybe we should have a butler like Hotchkins to do it, huh?
Yeah, Jake, maybe we should. I'll think about it.
No, Mom, I'm only fooling him. I'll open the door for you myself, Mrs. Fink, myself.
Goodbye, Becky. Don't forget to come over for tea. Maybe sometime next week.
Yeah, thank you. I will, Mrs. Fink. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye,
Mrs. Fink. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Jay.
Yes, Becky?
You know, I'm wondering whether Mrs. Fink is telling the truth.
The truth, Becky? What about?
Jake, don't stand up there and tell me you believe there's a fountain hundreds of feet up in the air with hot and cold running water.
Well, maybe there is, Mama. Maybe there isn't. You know, 20 years ago, I didn't believe I would today be making uniforms in the knee pants factory. I didn't believe I would have a vice president in charge of sales. But today, I got Harold in a fancy office. Who knows what might happen?
Yeah, that's right. And we got radios and things like
sure.
that.
Sure. Well, the doorbell, Mama. Maybe Mrs. Fink forgot something.
Jake, should I be a Houdini? That I see through the door? Answer it.
All right.
Hello, Paul.
Hello, Sarah. What are you doing here this early?
Oh, I stopped by the travel office and picked up these circulars and booklets. I thought you might be impatient to look them over before tonight.
Good.
Hello, Sarah, darling.
Oh, I can't stay a minute more. I'm meeting Sydney. We're going to have dinner in town and then come here. But I brought the booklets now. By the time we all get here this evening, you and Paul can have everything decided about the trip.
Yeah, let me see the books, Papa.
Yes, Mama. There, look here. Maybe Mrs. Fink was right. Here's the fountain, Mama. You see, look.
Let me see. Oh, Jake, I'm ashamed of myself. I thought Mrs. Fink was telling a big flip.
Fib, Ma.
I thought she was lying. Papa, I think we will leave in 2 weeks.
2 weeks? Becky, you made up your mind.
Yeah. Sarah, I want you to take these books back and get me some other ones.
Take them back, Becky, but we ain't even seen them.
Why, I thought you were so anxious to have them, Ma.
I was.
Becky, sometimes I don't understand you. Why don't you want the books now?
Why should we look at books or someplace where we ain't going to?
Oh, Ma, you're not going to back out now.
Sarah, I'm not backing out or even going sideways. I'm just saying we are not going to Yellowstone Park.
Mommy, you're talking foolish already. You got the tickets.
We can exchange them for other ones.
Other ones?
Other ones. For Hollywood.